Here's a physics problem in rotational motion, challenge problem. You throw a bowling ball onto a lane. You throw it with a sideways velocity of 4 meters per second, but it's not spinning. So when it hits the lane, it starts to skid. But gradually, it's going to start spinning as it skids, and eventually it starts just rolling without slipping. How far does it skid? There are a lot of different parts to this problem, so it gives us lots of practice with the ideas. Here we go. Let's start with a force diagram. Gravity acts at the center. It presses on the floor, so there's normal force upward at that point of contact. And the ball is scraping, right? So we have kinetic friction trying to slow it down. That points to the left. There's our force diagram. What's the point of a force diagram? To write F equals ma. So sum of forces y equals mayy. Law of nature, always true. That means we have normal force up minus mg down equals zero because the ball is not going up and down. So the normal force equals mg, and since the mass is 4 kilograms, that's 39.2 newtons. Meanwhile, sum of forces x equals max. So minus mu k fn equals max. Mu k is 0.3. The normal force is 39.2, the mass is 4 kilograms, and the acceleration x we can solve for. So the acceleration x is negative 2.94 meter per second squared. In fact, the mass of the ball canceled in that. Next, let's start talking about the rotation. How hard it is to get this thing rotating, right? With linear motion, you just have the mass, 4 kilograms. But for rotation, we have to compute the moment of inertia. For a solid sphere, it's 2/5 mr squared. That comes from calculus. If you plug in 4 kilograms and the radius of 0.1 meter, or 10 centimeters, you get 0.016 kilogram meter squared. Another thing you can do with a force diagram, not just F equals ma, but also torque equals I alpha. So I usually write every single force with a torque symbol, and then say, all right, which of these are zero? If we choose this to be the pivot point, then since torque is Rf sine theta, this has an R of zero for the mg because it's right there. The normal force has an R of radius and it has a force, but the angle from the pivot to the force along the force, that's 180. The sine of 180 is zero. In other words, the normal force is pointing right at the center of the bowling ball, and if you push or pull on the center, you don't spin it. So Fn makes no torque. The force of kinetic friction is the only one that makes a torque. Minus, because it's clockwise, R times force of kinetic friction times the sine of the angle, and the angle there is 90 degrees. From the pivot to the force, along the force, draws the angle. Moment of inertia, we calculated, and we can find alpha. And when we plug in the numbers, we get negative 73.5 radian per second squared equals alpha. That's a lot of angular acceleration. It's twisting really hard. Now for the tricky part, the kinematics. V equals V0 plus AT, and omega equals omega 0 plus alpha T. And we know what the A is, and the alpha, and the V0, and the omega 0 is 0. So we have two equations, one that gives V for T, and one gives omega if you have T. But what happened to V equals R omega? When something's spinning, that's supposed to be the speed, right, of the rim. But here's the thing, the ball is skidding. While it is skidding, the velocity keeps going down and the omega keeps going up. And that's going to happen until they synchronize. Once you hit V equals R omega, then it will start rolling. There's one more sneakiness here because I defined positive x to be that way, and I defined counterclockwise to be positive. So really, the way I defined things, V equals negative R omega. That's the condition for rolling without slipping, and that's when it stops skidding. So that's the time we want to know. When V equals minus R omega, we have this expression equals minus 0.1 meter times this expression. When we solve that, we get the time is 0.389 seconds. And when we plug that into regular kinematics for x, we get 0.39 meters. That is how far the bowling ball skids before it starts rolling. So to recap a sneaky point, when something is skidding that should be rolling, the V's are out of sync. There's a V for the speed of the rim of the wheel, and there's a V for how fast the ball is moving. And usually, when things are rolling without slipping, those two match. But with the ball skidding, they were two different velocities. The velocity of the rim of the ball and the velocity of the ball were two different numbers, and we had to wait for V to go down and omega to go up until they synchronized. The moment they did, it stopped skidding, and it began rolling without slipping, so there's no more friction. I thought that was an interesting problem. I hope you did too. Thanks for watching.